Welcome to Muncher Movies Game of Thrones Wagers, Episode 2.
We started with 1,000 Muncher Coins. We have episode bets that get settled at the end of every episode. We have death wagers that get settled every time the character dies. And some season-long bets that get settled as the season progresses.
And these wagers are open to you, our good listeners, as well. You can weigh in on a wager through comments on YouTube or social media platforms or our website. You can find us at Muncher Movies or munchermovies.com. We'll keep score of the wagers for you as they happen, and the winners stand to get some Game of Thrones or Muncher goodies.
With that, Vidur, why don't we relook at some wagers from last week and see how those settled?
Firstly, Vikram, relook is not a word. And secondly, I think the phrase you're looking for is, why don't we take a look at last week and see how Vidur owned Vikram? Because as I was watching the episode...
Unfortunately, I'm not going to... Not going to fight that.
Just the deliciousness of watching a filler episode that I predicted to the T. Ugh, it was beautiful.
Well, let's just get going, can we, please?
Sure, why don't we start with something that I won, since that's going to happen often. Why don't we just start over there?
Sure, why don't we start with how many character deaths we were going to see.
Filler episode. Dun, 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 dun. I got it right.
Your wager was zero, and I said more than one, and obviously it was zero.
You lowballed, and yet...
So yes, 10 Muncher coins to you for that one.
Cha-ching!
Next one was how many on-screen deaths we were going to see.
Nailed it as well.
Well, six or under now just seems preposterous, right?
I know.
they're literally zero again. So 20 Muncher coins to you.
Yeah, dude, this episode was filler in so many ways, but that's what traditional Game of Thrones used to be. But traditional Game of Thrones also had deaths. And I'm so glad this one didn't.
Well, I mean, traditional Game of Thrones, if the last season wasn't a thing, I would have been placing these wagers completely differently. But last season just sort of skewed expectations in terms of what might happen.
Come on, dude. You got to be smart. You got to think about the next episode preview that they put out.
We had the entire season going. Can you stop getting cocky already?
With 30 Muncher coins, I'm just so elated.
So the next one was how many instances of nudity we were going to see.
Nailed it as well.
Vidur, you said one and under. Wow. Brave, brave bet by you.
It had one exactly. A good old Arya. We had to sit through that. Am I off in saying that was weird? I know plenty of people online agree with me, but... Plenty of people also think, like, why should it be weird? I'm
on that board because Arya's character, man, like, it completely makes sense. Like, she's not Arya the little girl. She's Arya Stark.
Dude, I want to look away. And, you know, in my head, I just convinced myself it's a body double. I was just like, don't treat this seriously. It's
right,
a body double.
Right.
I don't want to see Arya in that situation or position.
Anyway, moving on to one that I finally won.
No, but first let me gloat. Even though I did not enjoy seeing it, thank you, Arya, for being the only nude person in that episode.
Yeah, take my 10 coins, man. Just shut up. Okay, we go on to one that I won, finally.
Oh my god, that happened?
How many instances of the F word? Mr. Stander Clegane came in clutch for me there.
You mean the fact that nobody else came in clutch for you?
Well, there's a reason I did two and under, and you took the over on that. So some nice 10 Muncher coins come back my way. The next one was... whether we thought we were going to see either the Night King or his dragon.
Wait, just say it slowly. Because I get to gloat here so much. We all knew how episode 2 would end. We all knew, right? It would end with whites or white walkers or assumably the Night King staring at Winterfell. We all knew.
More or less. I mean, that army reaching Winterfell, essentially.
Exactly. Yeah.
And they showed everyone, the important white walkers, except for the Night King or his dragon. And
the slow zoom out. Towards, what was it, like 100 White Walkers?
Yeah.
That's why it was scary.
Yeah.
And I knew it, dude.
They showed that first horse, and then they were panning up, I was like, please be the Night King. Please be the Night King.
Because the Night King's going to be on Viserion, dude. I was like, please, 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 please. I thought another way to, like, button the scene would be you see the 100 White Walkers, and then suddenly you hear Ice Dragon Viserion.
Yeah,
I was like, yes, nothing,
30 coins, man. That one cost me heavy.
What a bet, dude. What a bet. I don't want to move on from the excitement of the Night King bet, but we must. On to the Generous Kiss bet.
Generous Kiss bet. I wasn't too sure about this one. And given how the episode progressed, obviously, there sort of wasn't any space for them to kiss, especially after their interaction.
Yeah, it was a small bet. And you know the fact that John just straight up blurted it out, which is what he does now?
Well, he had these three awkward scenes with Danny around multiple people, so...
they couldn't really kiss then.
And then suddenly the crypt scene where he's like, hey, you're my aunt.
I saw this meme where John says, hey, turns out you're my bua. And then she goes like, oh, really? In that case, yellow beast fair. 10 Muncher Coins to me. That was pretty easy. But I was afraid that Daenerys would try to kiss Jon and then he would like push her away. So I'm glad that didn't happen.
She kind of had like the complete opposite reaction, if you think about it. She suddenly became threatened. I think that was like the knee-jerk reaction she had.
Yeah, if I was her, I'd be threatened. Yeah, she didn't think about the incest either, by the way.
Also, love. I mean, come on, man. You love the guy.
She just said.
Forget about the only reason we talked about whether they would kiss or not. Yeah.
They didn't kiss. That's all I care about.
Yeah. Okay. So then the next bet was whether we thought we were going to see Melisandre or not.
Man, Red Woman, where were you, dude?
I can't believe you bet 20 coins on this one. Such an idiot.
I can't believe it now either, now that I lost. But I just want to see her, you know? I just want her.
Sure, man.
I want her in my life. And currently Game of Thrones is my life.
Well, you know who you really wanted to see and it actually worked out? Was Direwolves.
Ghost, baby. Ghost in the hood.
Just standing there on the side.
I missed it. The first time I watched the episode, I missed it. So I thought I lost this. And then apparently Ghost was just chilling next to Sam and I went back and watched it. 10 coins. Just
saving some CGI budget. Hey guys, remember Ghost is at Winterfell? Here you go.
Cha-ching, baby. Killed it this episode.
Anyway, so we ended up betting a total of 120 coins each. And yeah, I'm kind of like minus 90 on that right now.
Suck it.
Oh, man.
This is what you call an upswing, baby. Let's keep it continuing for the season.
Bring it, man. Bring it. I'm feeling good about the wagers for the next episode, though.
The next episode is episode 3, The Battle of Winterfell. It's going to be insanity.
A kill fest?
A kill fest. A slaughterhouse.
All right. Why don't we just take note of that and talk about how many name characters we think are going to die? Vidur, why don't you just give me a good over-under here?
You know, I haven't thought about listing all the character deaths. I'm just going to go on like just gut, vibe, feel.
Yeah. Swindle me. Try to swindle me, won't you?
No, I'm telling you. I'm just going to name a number, which is like, this is how many D&D Dan and David think should die.
Okay? In this episode.
Okay. In the Battle of Winterfell.
Okay.
For us to feel something.
Okay.
Okay, and I'm slightly informed by episode 2 with what we saw.
All right.
Over 5.
Over 5?
You didn't expect that, right?
Should we
just lock it? 30 coins.
Over 5 name character deaths. Don't swindle me.
Come on, dude.
I've come to learn your ways with it.
I'm not even asking for odds here. Over 5.
I'll do 20 on under 5. Because I do feel like a lot of name characters are going to die. It might be at least 5. So I'll take your under, but I'll do it for 20.
Nope. 30 or no bet?
No bet then.
No bet?
Because I really feel like a lot of people are going to die.
I'll do over 4 for 20.
No, that makes no sense.
You caught on to that?
Yeah. So you're trying to swindle me. I'm just like a nice-natured boy trusting his friend here. And then you are.
I set the line so high to make you just immediately take it.
Take 20 or shut up and move on.
I'm betting big on this episode, man. So I gotta have the risk to like, I gotta have the juice. You know?
20 coins is good juice.
All right, fine. You pretty much got what you want there. You get an absurd bet for a low price of 20 Muncher coins. All right, that's a lock. How about... We get to some of the big stuff, man. The fact that the Night King is coming for Bran, that's huge.
Well, that's what Bran thinks.
That's what Bran thinks. I mean, we have a season bet on this.
Yeah.
And I know what you're going to say, that it's not confirmed yet.
It cannot be confirmed. The season bets will end once the season's over.
No, that's BS. I mean, if something gets confirmed during the season.
Well, by one character, but the plot hasn't confirmed it.
I'll concede for this one. I think there's like a 10% chance, but I mean, I'm basically a lock, so I don't care. I'm getting the Muncher coin anyway. What about episode 3? Do you think, in terms of the plan that they have of Bran being bait, do you think the Night King will get to Bran? Like, will the Night King lock eyes or touch Bran? Let's just say either of those two.
Lock eyes? I think that leaves it vague. So if you just go back to the original question, which is, will he sort of get to Bran essentially, or will that plan work, quote unquote? I think the setup there is too weak for it to actually happen. So I don't think that's going to happen. Lock eyes, yeah, I think it'll happen.
You think so? I think so too.
They'll lock eyes for sure. I mean, there'll be some sort of confrontation there.
Okay, then there's no bet. But, you know, I could have seen this going either way too, because the fact that we know the plan should be enough reason for the plan not to happen. But, you know, hey, that's how these things go. How about some more exciting stuff, dude? Speaking of the Bran and the Night King locking eyes, good versus evil, mano a mano, tete-tete.
Mm-hmm.
How about a dragon off?
Ooh, dude.
Viserion the Blue versus...
Either Drogon or Rhaegal. You know what? Just for the spirit of wagers here, I'm not too sure, or I don't feel too strongly whether this is going to happen, but I really want this to happen. So I'll bet on the yes.
What do you mean? I want it to happen too. Of course. What kind of a monster?
But do you think it'll happen?
That is up for grabs. I mean, how are we defining this? I think they have to shoot fire at each other for this to happening.
Or collide mid-air. Or touch each other. Some sort of whatever the version of a dogfight for dragons is.
Yeah. But if both of them are using fire on not each other, that doesn't count, right?
Yeah. I mean, do think about it. It's an open battlefield and two dragons are out there firing each other's armies. They have to.
It's like chess, Vikram. Like when you have
two chess
queens,
when you have two dragons firing.
When you have two queens, they don't both go for each other. Sometimes the queens go for the pawns.
Also, she has two dragons versus Night King's one. So I feel like there'll be some sort of dragon.
Yeah, wait. Come to think of it.
No. Come on. I loved your argument, by the way. I think it made complete sense.
I never locked it. Okay. And I would like to change it. Take it or leave it. Viserion versus Drogon only.
No, I'm not a gambler like you, man. I still think a dragon off is happening.
Danny versus Night King. 30 Muncher coins.
No, it could be Jon versus Night King as well.
That's my point. Jon versus Night King, you lose.
No, I'm just overall a yes on dragon offs.
Fine, I'll do it for 10.
Okay, fine, for 10.
10 Muncher coins it is. Just to keep the juice alive, you know?
Just a gambler, dude. You're such a gambler.
Speaking of gambling, here's a man who would gamble, Bronn. Do you think we'll see him in this episode? Do you think that storyline is leading towards him being a part of the Battle of Winterfell somehow?
You know what? One thing that sort of purposely, I'm assuming, left ambiguous was his sort of... When Kywin gave him that bow, apparently his instructions were that if they do survive the fight,
true,
and then they're coming this way, you have to kill them. So I don't know if Bronn's going to venture all the way towards Winterfell to kill them off.
Are you a no then?
But the question here is, will we see Bronn? So we could maybe see Bronn just embarking on the journey towards...
It's a meta risk. It's not that it will be at Winterfell.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'll go with a yes.
Yeah, I'll go with no.
Okay, cool.
It's not his time yet to be seen.
Yeah, makes sense. All right. So let's just do a small one on this. How about a 10?
Okay, 10 Muncher coins it is. Oh, wait. So now I'm rooting for Bronn not to be in the episode. I kind of wanted to be like the secret, Deus Ex Machina of the Battle of Winterfell. But I don't think narratively that makes any sense whatsoever.
And given, Bronn's character is not sort of the heroic ones. I don't know. His character's kind of weird when it comes to Jaime and Tyrion particularly.
You know how in episode 2 bets, we knew the episode is filler, right? We had all this information. In episode 3, we know this episode is a battle, the longest battle ever filmed. It's going to be insane. Do you think the episode will have time for, say, even Cersei? Or will it be a very contained episode?
Well, you know, they don't release episode titles beforehand. The first one ended up being Winterfell. The second one ended up being the Night of the Seven Kingdoms. I feel like this one is going to be the Battle of Winterfell.
Mm-hmm.
Because of that and because of how they've sort of shown Cersei whenever they needed to only, this episode might just be dedicated to the battle. And having said that, I did do a yes on Bronn, so I don't know which way to go.
Yeah, but Bronn can use the Game of Thrones geography time vortex right now to actually be wherever he wants. But Cersei has to be in King's Landing. I actually think we might see her.
You do? All right, I'll take a no on that.
If I was making this episode, I would make sure that I juxtapose this woman who's waiting there if you lose.
Oh, so you feel like...
Or if you win, sorry.
Like during the end of the episode?
Sometime, at some point. 20 Muncher coins?
Fair enough. All right, let's do 20 coins on this. Let's go.
Done. Since we are somehow wagering on battle results at this point anyway, why don't we do the big one? Who wins the Battle of Winterfell?
This is a tough one. Let's define winning here.
So winning means the good guys, the Winterfell Jon Snow army, defeats the Night King. And we'll know. We'll know if they defeat the Night King, right? And losing means a very likely scenario, possibly, is that they have to retreat. And because they keep... Why am I giving this information? Where are you on this?
I'm actually very curious to know what you think a draw is in this situation.
A draw? That's a good point. There is no draw, is
it's
there?
It's episode 3. It has to be either or. There can't be a draw. They can't be just like, okay, you can... Okay, we drew this. We're moving on.
You know what? You're right then. I misspoke. So then I think all the retreat scenarios should count as lose.
Okay. Well, I think they're going to lose then.
Okay. I'm actually willing to go win. You know why? Because I'm still optimistic about like Game of Thrones subverting expectations. And there's this meta layer going on where it's episode 3. It seems destined that they're going to lose. But maybe I'm on just a whole different level here because most people think they're destined to win. I just think the fact that it's not episode 6 means that they're going to lose. So a fun thing for them to do would be to make them win and make Cersei the big threat.
So the whole Night's King and the White Walker side of the story sort of gets solved?
Yeah, so I don't want it to be like everything is solved. Listen, like the White Walkers and the Night King might retreat in some way. But essentially, like the good guys have some semblance of winning. Okay, so even if Winterfell is completely destroyed, but the Night King is defeated, that's obviously still a win. So all those scenarios, we can sort it out. I mean, who knows what's going to happen?
I'm sure if anything like that occurs in the episode, we'll know. You're right. I know
I'm taking the lower edge side here, but you know what? I just want it to be subversion. So let's go slightly big. I want to feel the juice when...
All right, let's do it, man.
Let's go 30.
30? All right. So you're saying the good guys win.
Somehow.
And 30 Muncher coins. I'm feeling weird about this one, but yeah, I'll take your bet. Let's do it.
Great.
You know, one thing that we ended up seeing in the preview, as well as the season trailer before the season dropped, was Arya running in the crypts.
Oh, yeah.
Slightly wounded. Who do you think she's running from?
This obviously was all the rage in terms of theorizing when the trailer dropped.
Yeah.
And a lot of people seem to think that it's going to be like some Stark come back to life.
Like dead Starks, right?
Yeah, but they're all bones. Like, I know some of the whites are skeletons, but that would be stupid.
There's also this other theory about how they keep saying there should be a Stark in Winterfell. And some people out there think that the dead Starks are going to be led by the good guys versus the dead people, which, I don't know, it seems like a little too far-fetched.
What is this, the Mummy 3? That's stupid.
It's Game of Thrones, honestly. It could be anything.
I spend way too much time watching a video about there's always a Stark in Winterfell. And the only way I think that could be relevant in the Battle of Winterfell is if we actually start addressing the fact that the Night King is a Night's King, which is one of our season wagers. And he was a Stark, and then he takes over Winterfell, and now there's a Stark in Winterfell. Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Coming back to the season trailer and who might be chasing Arya, I have a pretty strong theory here now. It has to be, in my estimation, Gendry.
Gendry alive or Gendry dead?
Gendry dead.
Ooh, that's very interesting.
That would explain so much about how she would be all messed up about it. And
you know what? It could also be another family member she's close to. Could be like whom? A Sansa, for example.
That implies Sansa dies.
Yeah.
There's no way Sansa's dying. Do we have a death wage on Sansa? No, we don't.
Yeah, we don't. But I mean, things change, man. I'm just proving your point here. It could literally be the Hound as well. Like, she's grown to love the Hound a little bit now.
I'm going all in on Gendry. Like, you can't just take
Dead Gendry.
But you can't take not Gendry, though. You have to pick someone.
You know what? I like your dead Gendry option. I just really want to see that happening. But I feel like it's not going to be dead Gendry. I feel like it's going to be a White Walker, maybe.
That's like saying not Gendry. There's a lot of White Walker. A White Walker.
Yeah, not a White. A White Walker.
That's fair. That's 50-50.
All right. Do you want to do 20 coins on this?
Because it's so improbable for either of them to come true in the wide spectrum. It could be anything, right? So let's. If one of us is right, that should be rewarded.
Fair enough. So
50?
All right, let's do 50 coins on this.
Oh, this is a big one, dude. If I'm right about this, that'd be sweet.
Dude, if you're right about this, mad respect. Mad respect, or you've seen some leaked footage from the third episode.
Oh, baby, I feel good about this one, man.
All right, since we're talking about dead Gendry and dead name
characters.
Let's
talk about Donald Trump. I don't know. Let's use that often.
Who do you think is going to have the highest on-screen kill count?
Oh, we're getting in the weeds of the battle here, man.
Yep.
This is tough, dude. This is tough. There's some... Let me list down the candidates. Then I want to know where you're at.
Okay.
There's Brienne.
Yep.
There's the Hound.
Yep.
There's Jaime, but not really because he admitted defeat. But we should also count some like smart maneuvers. It could very well be Tyrion.
It could be Tyrion, dude. It could be Tormund. It could be Jon.
Oh, Tormund. I didn't even think about
Jon's
that.
Jon's fighting Daenerys with her dragon. I mean, think
dude,
about that.
Would we even be able to keep count? That would require like 3 viewings.
I mean, dude, I think instead of keeping count, what we'll be able to sort of ascertain pretty easily is who has the highest kill count.
It could be Grey Worm. It could be Jorah. It could be Beric.
It could be Arya. It could be anyone.
Oh, it could be Arya.
There's so many candidates. Arya has that new weapon, man. Like, there's some purpose of that. Gendry
could be. Dude, we need to put some limits here, man. Like, how do we count who gets killed by Dragonfire? Jon and Daenerys should just get taken out firstly of the equation.
Okay, that's fair. I guess everyone with the dragon's sort of not allowed here.
All 3 people. Yeah. It could be one of the White Walkers who has the highest kill count. Also, when you kill a White Walker, all the whites die. Wait. This is getting too confusing. How about any kills with a sword or a weapon only?
But that a Valyrian steel on a White Walker kills all of the whites associated with
that
White Walker.
And that counts as one.
That counts as one?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. All right, let's do that. So again,
wait. How do you even see a white die? This is a bad bet.
Because as soon as they pierce with dragon glass, you assume they're dead.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, so they disappear? Or they just
No,
die?
The whites don't disappear. The whites just die.
Just getting confused.
Everyone either has Valyrian steel or dragon glass weapons. Who's fighting, right?
Okay, let's be open to not just being able to count this. But otherwise, I'm down to bet on it. Let's do the same thing as the Gendry bet and like pick one character and bet big on it because there's so many candidates.
Okay, let's do that. I like that idea, but let's limit our character count to 5 and then choose between that pool of 5.
Okay, Brienne.
Brienne's there. You know who we didn't talk about was Pod. They showed his mad fighting skills.
Nah, he's going to do 1 or 2 at most. Come on.
All right, so we have Brienne. We have Tormund.
Tormund, the Hound.
The Hound. Jon, Sans, Dragon.
Nah, that's out.
What?
Jorah,
he has a new sword for sure.
And Grey Worm. I think those are the 5 candidates.
Okay, so we have Grey Worm, Jorah, Tormund, Brienne, and the Hound.
I call the Hound.
I call Brienne.
Done.
All right.
50?
No.
What do you mean no?
Dude, do you...
More?
No.
Dude, how about say 40 Muncher Coin?
40?
Yeah, it's
dude, you're betting on the high side, man. All right, let's do 40. Why not? Let's do 40. So I choose Brienne and you choose the Hound.
I have one that relates to what we were just talking about. Will Samwell Tarly kill someone?
I think he will. I think he'll kill at least one, either dead or White Walker.
I thought so too, but then he gave his sword away.
He did, but then he has this sort of responsibility of protecting Gilly and his son. Like someone, I see like a White Walker or a White breaking into the crypt and Sam sort of stabbing him.
Dude, I know this is so not like a Game of Thrones fan, but I'm getting so overloaded in my head just imagining these scenarios that I'm just not even letting myself think of it. It's like too much to think about. Because now when you were talking, I was like, yeah, for sure, whites are going to come into the crypt.
Dude, it's and the biggest Samwell... battle ever filmed. Shit's going to go down. Sam's going to kill someone.
Then I can't bet against you. You're right. I think Sam will kill someone as well.
Okay, so that's no bet. Again, you guys, our good listeners, are always welcome to wager in. And let us know if you think you want to wager otherwise. You guys have 1,000 Muncher Coins as well. And we're going to keep tab on who wins, who loses by the end of the season. So let's get it going.
If you think Samwell might not kill someone in episode 3, let us know.
Moving on to the last wager we have for this episode. It's Tyrion related. Has to be.
Tyrion.
You think he's up to no good? You think he has something up his sleeve?
There's a lot of Tyrion wagers that we can do, but they're all kind of ambiguous in my head. Because you know,
that's Tyrion, man.
That is Tyrion. That's true. One, he talks to Bran and the scene cuts away.
Yeah.
He's like the only person who's ever asked Bran, yo, what's good, bro? Like, yeah. What you been up to, man?
And Bran's like, it's a long story. He's like, yeah, man, we got all day, all night. Yeah. Let's do it.
Bran's like, I'm weird. Tyrion's like, I am too. Like, misfits, let's talk. So there's that. He did that. Also, you know, everything that happens now in Game of Thrones feels like it should be foreshadowing. So he tells Davos and Jorah that I suspect that you guys will be wearing this pin.
Yeah, but then that happens when Dany sort of gives it off to him. And then that sort of changes after Davos tells Dany. So,
but these kind of things are usually foreshadowing.
Right? I think the bigger foreshadowing was Dany trying to force him to go to the crypt so that he can preserve his mind, which is the most useful thing here.
And then he doesn't.
Yeah, I mean, till the episode ends, he's
still
there.
At least when the horn blows.
Yeah, so that sort of means that he's still there.
What do we mean up his sleeve? I mean, I guess, like, if he does something out of the ordinary, like, based on his conversation with Bran.
That's true, but then there's usually nothing ever that's ordinary with Tyrion, is there?
So if he does something like the Battle of Blackwater, would that count as something?
That is definitely something non-Tyrion, yeah.
Yeah, Tyrion always has something up his sleeve.
That's true, man. That's true, and it's so tough to sort of nail down.
Are you yes or no? You think that he doesn't, right?
Okay, I still feel like it's going to be a no for me on this one. I guess we'll know once it happens, if it does, in the episode.
Yeah, for sure. Listen, I can see why you would go no as well, because there's so many characters. If this was the Battle of Blackwater and suddenly Tyrion was the man in charge, of course he has something up his sleeve. Here, it's up to other people to have something up their sleeves, but I think just the conversation with Bran seems to imply that he's going to be doing something. Why don't we go small? How about like a little 10 Muncher Coin bet?
Sure, let's do that. So that's locked in. 10 Muncher Coins, you think he does have something up his sleeve?
Yep, locked in.
Aha, got you. I think that Bran conversation is something that's going to play out a little later, not in this episode.
Oh, you played me with the episode season thing.
Ha ha ha.
Ah, well, I'm glad we bet low then. I hear you. Yeah, it could go either way. I like it. I like the bet still. So that wraps up our wagers for episode 3 and some juicy settlement for me for episode 2. What do we need to settle in the season-long wagers, Vikram?
Well, 2 things that came to light were our wagers on who the Night King's target is.
Yeah, so as we discussed, Bran is clearly calling himself the target, but he might not end up being the target, but you have to admit, I pretty much won that. It's 90% there.
No.
Episode two, man.
Episode two without any action. That is one of the bets that I feel like can't be settled already.
We're setting ourselves up for such disappointment because every time Game of Thrones will tell us something or show something, you'll just hold out and be like, nope, it's just episode five.
It's not the Game of Thrones way, man. It just isn't.
Yeah, you'll just be like, oh, wait, let the prequels come out. It's not settled yet. Jeez.
And the other one is whether we think Cersei is pregnant or not, which sort of Jaime quote-unquote confirmed.
Another wager that I won, but you can push back and say, oh, we don't know for sure yet.
Of course, Jaime, beginning of the episode, clearly said that I don't know what my sister is doing. She lied to me. So how can he be like, no, that one's true, bro. That's bullshit, dude.
Wow.
So, no one knows what Cersei's doing except for Cersei.
We'll wait. Make sure you pay me interest on my Muncher Coins.
There's no interest happening. Forget about that, okay? It's obviously, you can't take the word of Jaime, who literally at the beginning of the episode conceded that his sister lied to him.
But then he said that she was telling the truth about.
Oh, man, guys, up. Yeah. That's what we're taking Lannister word for this now. No way, man.
Oh, my God, you're so desperate. It's okay. On a week that I own you like this, I understand where you're coming from.
Yeah. Gloat. And when Cersei is not pregnant and we find that out for sure...
Then you reverse gloat. No
full power reverse gloat is going to happen. Okay, so with that, why don't we talk a little bit about the death wages we've set for the entire season?
Well, firstly, no deaths. Haha, that's the episode wager that I won.
Of course.
Nothing changes. That's why we locked in the death wages. I mean... we're going to write them out and see what happens. Unless you want to wimp out and settle on any of them.
Nope.
Because a lot of deaths seem to get a little spicier, a little more probable this episode. Basing them purely on the fact that character arcs ended, women got knighted, people were given Valyrian steel swords that their fathers first gave to someone else and then they got it back from the pupil's father.
No, that did not happen. Jorah Mormont did not get back his father's sword.
But he got back a sword that his father had a hand in, like...
His father had no hand.
Pupil, mentor. His father was a mentor to the guy.
Stop talking.
Okay.
Stop. Jorah Mormont had nothing to do with Heartsbane. Yeah. But again, so we laid out a lot of wagers in terms of who we think is going to die. And I feel like a lot of them sort of come into play or will come into play in this next episode.
Let me start with one that I think has been affected that not enough people are going to talk about.
Yeah.
I think Lyanna Mormont's a goner.
You do?
Why is she so desperate to fight?
I got that feeling too. I got that feeling between either her or Jorah Mormont getting offed. And with Lyanna Mormont, we had no bet.
Even though now I'd be willing to take a bet on her dying. But you know what? It's so close to the episode and I just wanted to survive. So I'm cool keeping a no bet.
You know, one interesting death wager that comes to my mind basis of your episodic wager is the Night King dying.
Hmm. I have always been a yes in that. And I know we've been confused about what would count as the Night King dying. And clearly I'm committing, man.
And I feel like it came across that you strongly think that this might be the episode where he just poof.
I'm on a whole different level with the show, man. I think the right thing for the show to do would be to make the Night King threat go away in some fashion or the other. So listen, the Death Wager is season long. It doesn't need to happen in the next episode.
Right.
But I'm still pro the Night King dying.
Okay, fair enough. And I think one that I truly feel might happen in this episode is Brienne.
I knew it. I knew you were going to say that. Her arc is done.
Her arc, you know, her arc, Jorah's arc, for example, as well. It just feels like they're just stitching these sort of open loops closed so that, well, they're just setting themselves on the show.
All these knights, all these sirs.
Yeah, and then, you know, Jorah being like, you know, her getting knighted, finally, tears in her eyes, finally achieved what she set out for.
Not just her eyes, Vikram.
Did you cry?
Maybe.
Okay. Well, I wanted to watch this episode with you then. But I think Brienne's gone, man.
Let's just say I feel pretty scared about our bet here. Because I had this hope that she doesn't die. I thought she had a role in the kingdom to come. And no, I don't think so. I thought she was going to be like the head of the King's Guard in like whoever sits on the Iron Throne.
Yeah.
And here we are ready for her to pop.
And also like they mentioned in the show that her sort of her unit, her regiment is going to be on the left flank, which is going to be furthest away from
the army. Think about that.
And then the preview showed her literally just gearing up for an onslaught.
Oh my God.
So I think she's gone, man.
Oh no. What about Jorah Mormont? His is over too, as you said.
Yeah, Jorah Mormont just, you know.
His arc is done as well, as you said.
Felt like it, right? Like just... asking Khaleesi for one last favor.
He could have died at any point, actually, dude. It wouldn't have mattered.
Yeah, but now's the perfect time to kill him. I think he's going to be one of the name characters that go. So
That's true, because he also says that Khaleesi made the right decision with Tyrion.
And he said bye to his cousin.
Yeah.
Little cousin. That was a little weird.
Okay. I mean, Jorah is not going to survive this one. But I guess we always felt that way. So we didn't have a bet to begin with. What else is worth looking at in terms of death wager based on this episode?
I think Bran and Arya are two good ones to look at.
So Bran, I thought, might die in some fashion.
Right.
Like Bran being the three-eyed raven, not surviving. We're a lock anyway, but I still feel pretty good about that bet because he's not built to survive. He needs to make someone else the new three-eyed raven somehow.
But do you think that's going to happen this episode?
No, I don't think so. But I just think in the grander story, probably unchanged.
Interesting. And what about Arya?
Arya, dude. You remember what I did for Arya? 50 Muncher Coins?
Yeah.
And I feel much better about that bet now. Again, it doesn't need to be in the Battle of Winterfell necessarily. But in a way, Arya's arc is almost over as well, right? Like, the fact that she asserted her sexuality with Gendry. It, of course, means that she's going to battle, but it's also a way to show someone dying, right? Like, doing everything she wants to do before she goes.
I guess. I don't see her arc closing anytime soon, though. That's just a lot more beneath the surface with Arya and her character. So, definitely not this episode. And I stick by my wager of her not dying at all.
It would take me a wager with odds to make a wager for if she dies this episode. But this is a big one. This is a big prediction, man. If I'm right about this, I'll feel mighty good about my theorizing.
Yeah, man. And looking through these wagers, it's just because of this battle and so many characters assembling at Winterfell, so many come into play. Samuel Tarly.
Dude, I feel like I'm staring at like a circus fair, like shooting gallery.
And they just pick, yeah, exactly. I know what you mean.
Yeah.
So we have Samuel Tarly, we have Tyrion.
I can't believe you think Samuel Tarly might die. Like, to me, he's the guy who writes the Song of Ice and Fire. And this episode just kind of confirms it. You know, he's not in the running to die.
I don't know, man. That's exactly why these guys are going to kill him, just to make you feel that way.
Maybe it is Game of Thrones. But can we talk about the most punty bet that I made? Except now I would buy out of it, but it's small, so I won't.
Okay, which is?
But if you're willing to give me a good buyout, I'm open to it.
What's the bet?
I thought the show would subvert expectations and make Missandei die and Grey Worm live.
Ooh, did I bet right on that? I did. I bet on Grey Worm dying.
But anytime any piece of fiction makes a character make retirement plans with their loved one as they head into battle, I mean, What is this show doing? I felt like I was watching LOC with Saif Ali Khan.
Oh God, what a reference. You know what? We could even out. They both could die.
Yeah, that would at least help me out. At least I'd be even on the bet.
You know, one that I really want to talk about is Theon, especially given his plans for protecting Bran.
Theon's gone, dude. I'm losing 20 Muncher Coins. I'll take a buyout there, actually. I'll take it.
No
10.
Buyouts. I need to even out here, man.
10 Muncher Coin buyout, dude?
Nope. No,
You're locking in 10 Muncher Coin right now.
No, I know what the buyout means here. You don't need to explain that to me, you swindler.
I always try to convince you by just explaining what a bet is.
Full power swindler. Oh, you know, one we have on here, which kind of ties in with your episodic wager is Gendry.
You want to buy out there, buddy?
No, not at all.
You don't think Gendry's going to die still?
No, I stick by my thing. Even though it's a hefty 20 Muncher Coins.
You and I are looking forward to a completely different show here.
Yeah, we are.
Oh, I feel good about the Gendry. Okay, that's fine. Don't take the buyout. Theon will make up for the Gendry bet.
Okay, and what about Davos Seaworth?
Gendry will make up for the Theon bet.
Okay, what about Davos?
Nah, nobody cares about Davos.
Well, you wagered that he's going to die. 20 Muncher Coins. Die.
My point is nobody cares about him. Hence, he's very expendable. He's going to die. He dead, son.
Oh, man. That's literally 3/4 of our death wagers.
Oh, my God. It's going to be crazy.
Oh, I cannot wait. I cannot wait.
So that wraps up our wagers for episode 3. It's going to be a crazy episode. So there's going to be a lot of settlement done in the next wagers episode. In the meanwhile, you guys, our listeners, let us know who you think you want to wager on. And feel free to comment or reach out on our social media. Or you can go to our website and you can place your own wagers. You all start with 1,000 Muncher Coins as well.
You can find us on social media and YouTube under Muncher Movies. And looking forward to seeing what you guys wager on.
Until next week. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.